Hi everyone, I just finished painting the background on my painting which I titled Couple in Costume at Balboa Park Centennial. And in this video, I'm going to show you how I did it. So here we go!
I've only made my preparatory sketch off camera because I'm not painting a lot of detail here because these things are really far away from the subjects. I don't know if you can see this, but I'm lining around the post with a very sheer version of the color I painted them with. They give a slightly blurred effect. I've just painted these light bulbs white, but I'm going over them with gray because I've decided they should be sheer. In order to capture the faint pink glow I see coming from them in my reference photo, I'm going to lightly touch each bulb with a light pink that I mix combined with a large amount of matte medium. I'm finishing each bulb with a little drop of white to create shine. I'm painting the lamppost now, and I can see in my reference photo that it's a blue-gray. The color I mixed came out pretty dark, so I used it to fill in the post. I'll then mix more white into my original color and use it to paint thin lines close together with a 1-inch round brush to create the look of ridges. For the bulb itself, I painted the bulk of it titanium white, then went over that with a single layer of blue mixed with gray and a lot of medium to make it sheer. I had just a drop of paint on my brush while I laid this color down using a filbert brush. I'm going back to the upper left corner now and painting a thin line of green mixed with brown using a round brush. I'm then mixing a lot of medium into my mixed brownish green and quickly painting a very sheer patch. This thing is very far in the background, so I'm not putting in a lot of detail. I want to be almost hazy in a way. Now I'm going all the way to the far upper right-hand corner and painting the tree branch. I started out painting it burnt sienna, then switched to burnt umber. Again, I'm not putting in a lot of detail here because this tree is very far away from the subject. Just going along here, focusing on my values. I'm using transparent white and titanium white on the leaves to show brightness. As I paint here, I'm using a filbert brush, only touching the tip of the canvas, use short, quick movements of my wrist. Glazing over the gray with brown here and purple on the other side because that's what I see reflected. Thank you. enjoying painting the overhang. I have to say I'm very happy with the way it came out. I was surprised to see that my underpainting caused the dark parts to show through even before I added the shading. I wanted a bright color, so I'm using a base of cerulean blue here. I'm going to add ultramarine for the shadows. I'm not using black because when you add black or white to a color, it dulls it. I am, however, going to go along the edge with white to get a highlight. I'm going right over the still wet blue paint, mixing the colors right onto the canvas. A lot of my time painting is spent mixing colors on my palette, so being able to mix them straight onto the canvas is going to be very helpful in saving time. So I'm painting a yellow-green base and going over it with burnt umber and random masses to create that effect. As far as the fence goes, it looks very old and rustic, so to achieve that, I mixed up some gray and put a tiny touch of burnt umber into it. I used different variations of this color to paint both the fence and the box next to it, the latter of which was unfortunately painted off camera.
Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss me painting this lady. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!